Hi guys, I just wanted to check in before the weekend. I have another busy weekend, and in the following weekend I'm going away to Ohio for my oldest grandkid's high school graduation party. This weekend I have to make a lot of cookies and other stuff. So I just wanted to check in and talk to you a little bit. And right on the heels of the video I did on the Christ-hating devils, which was very annoying to make. but I really think it's important to see like where this all leads to and how bad is it really if something's New Age? You know, that's what it kind of boils down to. And how serious is it that this is yoking up with Christianity, even if it's Elijah-list or whatever. For instance, this one, Dr. Evil in googly eyes. Okay, I don't know if I'm going to call it that, but here we have Steve Schultz and this lady, Jan Halper Hayes, which I've never even heard of before. I just came across her, and what they talk about in this video is so repulsive, and it's so, like, kind of scary. But it really shows a really good example, another good example of how the letter after P, because they are straight up talking about that. They're talking about how many sealed indictments and white hats and tribunals. And it's so horrible. They're just giddy with excitement about martial law. They just can't wait. They can't wait. They're so excited for it. So that's what I'm almost finished with. And I am thankful that you guys like the Gnostic series I just did, and that I can just like sometimes just read. Speaking of that, I am going to re-upload, because on the Gnosticism one, this is another good series in that subject called The New Thing, which I put out early on. I don't know if very many people got to see it or hear it. It's really just reading, and there's no clips or anything. It's just me reading. So you can think of it like a podcast. But it's a really good... this is by Trisha Tillon. The reason it's so good isn't because I made it. Because I'm just reading. And Trisha Tillon has a website called Banner Ministries. And it's more archive stuff. She's doing different things now. But she was teaching, writing about this for decades before me. So I really appreciate finding people like her. And anyway, that one starts out, the first part is very good explanation of Gnosticism. It goes all through the history of the early Pentecostal, latter rain, and on. This was probably written in the 90s maybe, and she doesn't say New Apostolic Reformation, but that's really what it's leading up to. And she goes into a lot of the things that are going on, were going on at Toronto, etc. Anyway, and I've got a couple other ideas that I might do that are more of reading. There's a Daryl Giffen blog post about angels. Then there's a Christo Lover Dad series on mysticism, which I think would be really good. I think what I'm trying to do is sometimes I do point out certain particular individuals and things, but I think getting an understanding of the big picture and what does Gnosticism teach, what does the New Age teach, then anybody you're listening to, you can figure it out. You know, between reading your Bible and having some familiarity with these teachings that go way back, you know, really they go back to the beginning of time, in essentially. So, and I might, I don't know, I possibly might read the Constance Cumby book called The Planned Deception. I'm not sure. I might read just a few chapters, or I might read the whole thing. It's a PDF. Also, I'd like to point out that when I was listening today to the New Thing, which I was just talking about, I realized that in some of my earlier videos, my background music is too loud. It's distracting. Stuff like that. I'm not going to redo it. I've tried to tone it down. But I'm just saying, I realize that. And I'm also probably going to upload a couple other ones that are old. One is called Dark to Light, and it's about the whole idea that there is a whole dark to light on the in the occult, in the New Age, in the Freemasonry, and whatever. And I thought that would also be good to go along with the Dr. Evil and Googly Eyes, because what they're talking about, it's dark to light. So that's about it. I'm just gonna leave you with, I'm gonna read an encouraging Facebook post and throw in a few other odds and ends here at the end. So thanks for watching. Thanks for commenting. Love you guys. Take courage, little flock. This is from the Facebook group called These Aren't the Apostles You're Looking For. Don't be discouraged. Yes, it's overwhelming to live through these dark days of deception. As I've heard one pastor say, there's nothing great about the great apostasy. There's no pleasure in seeing God's word twisted and trampled from the pulpit to the pew. What's worse is the blank stare we get when we try to warn people about it. But here's one reason why you should be encouraged. You are literally watching the words of Jesus and the apostles coming to pass. Christ told us explicitly that many false prophets and anointed ones would come to lead many astray. Paul warned that days would come when professing Christians would lose all tolerance for sound doctrine. There have always been false prophets, but has the world ever seen the likes of this? Mainstream evangelicalism has assembled a panoply of poisonous preachers preaching themselves instead of Christ crucified. Be encouraged, little flock, for your shepherd is not caught unawares. He is moving everything forward exactly according to plan. He is reforming his true bride in these hours, and none of his lambs will be lost. False apostles and prophets haven't succeeded in shipwrecking your faith. Not yet. Not ever. Not if you're his royal possession. Stay focused. See the Lamb of God taking your sins away. See David's righteous branch who shall reign forevermore. See the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep. He says to the wolves, therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who care for my people. You have scattered my flock and have driven them away. You have not attended to them. Behold, I will attend to you for your evil deeds, declares the Lord. Jeremiah 23:2. Just wait, little flock, because one day very soon our King will come and execute justice. Then the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Habakkuk 2:14. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away. And he who was seated on the throne said, behold, I am making all things new. Also he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. Revelation 21:3-7. He who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all. Amen. Revelation 22:20-21. Our hope will not disappoint. Amidst the chaos, God is our refuge and strength. Hidden in Christ, we will be safe until he comes. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Luke 12:32.
Mia, you should see this. Oh,
Daisy.
I'm sorry.
The Lord told me to tell you there's going to be a season in your life that's going to be on a mountaintop. And on the mountaintop, there's going to be a plant. And when the plant grows, an astronaut will come and take it to outer space. Because see, when you get outer space, the planets of the universe is going to come forth. And ye that have reached down within you is going to strip the very fruit of the oranges and the grapes. And when the deer that's planted by the river come and try to male and go forth in the anointing, that a chair that you won't be able to sit in. There's going to be a car that you won't be able to drive. There's going to be a house that you won't be able to live in. There's going to be a cookie that will never be baked. And when your life depends on it, you're going to be able to fly with wings, not as an eagle, but with wings as a bird on top of a car that is moving. Your life will begin to speak things that have happened over the course of the years that McDonald's won't be able to prosper. God's going to do it for you.
With this strategy, we are calling for a great reawakening of America, a resurgence of confidence, and a rebirth of patriotism, prosperity, and pride. And we are returning to the wisdom of our founders.
Steve, I cannot tell you how much it grates me when people act as if they know and they give the wrong information. They are not done. This is going to be going on into 2025. You do not know how many corrupt people that they have to take care of. Too bad it can't be a firing squad and get them all to line up and go boom, 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 boom.
This is sick. This is sick. This is sick and disgusting. This whole thing is sick and disgusting.
And now for something completely different.
Yeah.
Vision came unbidden at an unexpected pass, where the winds of change blew colder, whipping snow that cut like glass. But like an old man in regret for foolish sins and wasted youth, the scene that lay before me had no beauty save its truth. For the wind came down the mountains, never slow and never still, and the sheep were scattered shepherdless, alone across the hills. They were prey to every beast that roamed, and entrapped by every curse. And they stumbled in their sickness, in their weakness, and their thirst. Below them in the valley, the polluted waters flowed, where the shepherds that were hirelings sat and argued what was owed. And the ambitious and abusive bragged, and they boasted on their might, and their profits from the slaughter of the ones who could not fight. And the wind just kept on howling as I cried, oh Lord, how long will your people be the victims of the ruthless, proud and strong? And once there came an answer in the quiet of my soul, the time has come for judgment and to make the wounded whole. For my heart is still a shepherd's heart, I know each one by name, the ragged and the beautiful, the healthy and the lame. And I myself will lead them out, and I'll feed them on the best, in pastures by still waters, in a place of peace and rest. Oh, but woe unto the shepherds who abuse my sheep and kill. With harshness and severity, you bent them to your will. And today I am against you as I take them from your hand. When the fire of judgment comes, the stubble will not stand. And darkness filled the valley, and I saw it take up more, screaming winds and fire and lightning, more than any earthly storm. Where it passed were no survivors, for the land was cleansed and bare, but the streams flowed clear and purified, and the grass grew green and fair. I saw a man come walking, and his heart glowed like a flame. All the sheep began to run to him, he called each one by name. He spoke to them in gentle words, and soothed their fearful minds. And he healed the brokenhearted, and the crippled, sick and blind. Then many others like him, all with hearts that glowed the same, that before I hadn't noticed, from the farms and fields they came. They weren't famous, wise, or noble, but they spoke a common word, a word the flock could recognize and follow when they heard. They led them in green pastures by still waters in the light, standing guard against the wolves and other creatures of the night. Going out into the mountains in the darkness and the cold, bringing back the lost and wounded to the safety of the fold. And the news went out around the world, every street and town, that something wonderful was here, that heaven had come down. And millions gave their hearts in trust, long had been betrayed. And the bride at last was ready, and the trumpet call was made. And the news went out around the world, every street and town, that something wonderful was here, that heaven had come down. And millions gave their hearts in trust that wrong had been betrayed, and the bride at last was ready, and the trumpet call was made.
Thank you.